All right, so welcome. We are ready, week three, class five. We start basically exploring going this week, and also in preparation for the third homework assignment, the composition three, which is published already today, is more experimental, contemporary or abstract composition techniques. And also see how from aesthetic, historical aspects of how music developed. And frankly, there was so much going on, you know, the film, the whole idea, you know, games and film, right? They're all kind of fusing music I don't want to say enhance, because then I would be totally kind of degrading the aspect of music, because I think music is very important, not just because I'm a music professor, but frankly, it adds so much to the experience. And even though maybe the main story and the main engagement goes in the visual domain, whatever goes, you know, under your skin in some sense, a lot of the impressions, a lot of the atmosphere and the emotion you leave with is related to sound, also diegetic, non-diegetic aspects of sound, voiceover sound effects. So since all of this kind of developed in the 20th century, a lot of the music theory and music practices had to be rethought in some sense, both in view of the changes that happened in music, in the music language, in musical aesthetics, and also because now music would serve other time-based domains. Of course, there was storytelling in music, there were dramas, theater, there were operas, but even in theater, you know, the use of sound that we have today, where you have, you know, speakers and somebody sitting and actually controlling a quite sophisticated audio engine that can be really dominant in the theatrical display. Before, it would be, you know, you could have musicians, you can have orchestras, you can have live musicians as part of the show, but I mean, it wasn't as integrated. And of course, in film, the silent films, you had the pianist who would play stuff together with, you know, things that happen on the screen. So the more that integration happened between other media and music, and the more changes happened in the music, people started rethinking basically basic questions about sound. So we'll explore the idea of sound and image relations, and then we'll talk about the contemporary composition techniques, which will be the topic of your next assignment. So let's get started. I will kind of briefly then overview the composition task, and let me see. Okay, yeah, I don't want to keep long videos, but let me jump in the first one, and then maybe I'll stop and take some questions, and we'll go from there to the remaining parts of the module. So, what are the sound and image relations? I mean, what kind of cinematic ideas that people were exploring. One important aspect of sound is how can it enhance or how it should relate sonically to something that happens on the screen. And there were different approaches by theorists. And one of them is so-called realism. Even that idea of reality, you know, music as something that refers to reality. I mean, I would encourage you kind of think of in general about what is the meaning of music, right? And does it have a specific description of something that happens outside of the musical realm? This is quite a difficult question. But kind of the idea that you could increase or emphasize specific meanings in visual domain by specific choices of music, that link, if you're trying to enhance what's going on and if what's going on the screen tries to depict an existing real situation, that might be called realism. Now, especially since in the a lot of theory was written in you know in the Soviet Union by so-called social realism. I mean, for some reason, in the beginning of or in the in the early 20th century, politics and arts were very much connected. So people would devote, although, you know, even before in the church, there are also, of course, some very specific rules about how to write music. So it will have a specific effect on the people who come to the sanctuary and give them a certain sense of, you know, greatness of God and stuff. You know, the Soviets wanted also to achieve certain effects with music. So they had rules. They actually, there was a battle between, you know, the West with their abstract and kind of decadent in the eyes of the Soviets, abstract art and the idea that there needs to be realism. But leaving politics apart, kind of the aesthetics, I think is pretty evident. So if we look at one example I brought here, which is the Alexander Nevsky by Russian composer Sergei Prokofiev. And we can see also here the battle scene. So the reason I brought both, because here as the music plays, you can see visually, and we kind of did this in the last class. We started looking into scores and trying kind of to get just as a texture and as a guide for listening, these little excerpts of music, how they can be actually manifested, or how this visual, the score representation can help us guide our listening, even without being, you know, a musician, or in this case, you know, a conductor who can read. That's the amazing thing about musical conductors, you know, the symphonic orchestra, all of these instruments. And, you know, in your homework, you also had this little instrumentation task where you would take maybe something which was written for piano and you'll break this into a lot of instruments. So here is like a full orchestra, right? With violins and violas these are the violins, violas, these are the cellos, violoncello. Okay, so the cellos, the double bass, the contrabass, percussion. And we kind of explore this notation of percussion. So I think now, even just like by going and doing our little game compositions, we already get a little bit more familiar with how music is written. And here you have basically the brass, the French horns, the trumpets, the trombones, and woodwinds with clarinets and flutes, and so on. So this is really how you create color. And here are the basic gestures, right? So kind of look at the chord excerpt at a certain point. Maybe I can jump to somewhere around here just to give an idea of some aspects of the score, which will be, make sure that we have the audio. No, we don't have audio. Okay, let me share it. Can we hear it? Yeah. So you can see that the kind of like the drop that happens, right? Ta-da. Thank you. So, I mean, you know, what would you feel, you know, what kind of sense? I mean, there's some kind of approach in danger, right? The low trembling sounds and then these sharp kind of like violin kind of short phrases. So how would like somebody match this or map this to visual experience? Let's take a look at some of these excerpts. Basically, this is a scene that describes a battle. And you can see that even like almost naively, Prokofiev tries to go and match some of the sharp sounds from the movie to... So you can see that kind of low line of enemy approaching. And then you have these violins. Actually, you know, there are some ways or some analysis that claims this kind of that idea of the sharp sounds, you know, the idea that you have these spears that are going down to hit each other. So I'm not saying we're taking, you know, the visual aspect here one to one and translate you know, these sharp visual elements to these sharp musical moments, but the design was actually meant to increase that realism, increase that emotion. So explore these films, and there are a few questions about this in the quiz. A very different approach, which is not supposed kind of to increase an impression of some event, which is an outside event, a very clear set of things that happen on the screen, but rather go more deeply inside the mind of the person, would be a very different approach to sound and a very different approach to movie and arts in general, which would be expressionism. So what is an expressionism? This is an artistic movement or a style approach that emphasizes kind of internal emotions, states of mind. Some aspect of expressionism goes to be surrealism, which even goes deeper into dreams, subconscious. And then there is this combination of surrealist expressionism, which kind of blends what is real and what your emotions and what you believe in, what you dream, your imagination, and your internal kind of mind state that becomes integral to your perception of reality. So the idea that surrealists actually explored, or one of the things that bothered them, almost opposite to the realist, was that if you want to kind of go and dive deeper into the mind of the person rather than what's happening in the reality, then sound in some sense interferes with this attempt. Because if anything is synchronized with actual events, definitely sound effects, but even if you have dialogue, noises, and music that kind of enhances the scenery, then it kind of brings the spectator more into the story rather than into, you know, what's going on in the mind of the people that are depicted in the story. So in that case, there was almost an anti-realist version or vision of how a music should be used in films. And the idea was that noises, dialogue should be exaggerated, deformed, made as fake as possible. This is the only use of speech or sound is likely to maintain all the benefits of silent film while altering its form and enriching its hypnotic power. And so in some sense, the surrealist and the expressionists were not happy with the idea that movies stopped being silent. I mean, for them, silent movie was maybe extension of a painting and surrealist painting that kind of emphasized, and a lot of them is kind of dark colors and dark expressions, but not if you want to now emphasize the internal state of mind of the person and painting and art in general in Europe became less realistic. You know, the idea was that you don't need to portray, don't do portraiture of people And even the impressionists, when they were painting the landscapes, the emphasis was on light and on impression rather than depicting the actual reality. You know, art was supposed to be, you know, going in some sense away from just photography that can so easily capture the reality. So in that sense, also recording, I mean, it should not be just a documentation of an existing sound. It has to be distorted. It has to be kind of processed. So this is an excerpt from this kind of surrealist expressionist movie, Wrapped. And in some sense for us, I think the use of sound is a little bit disturbing because it will be all intentionally not synchronized with the events that happen. But think about this whole idea that they would not allow themselves to make a sound, bring you back into the events. It's more about the dark thoughts that happen inside the minds of the people. So, so of course the use here is a very abstract recorded sounds, so-called electroacoustic composition. And even though we can think about this maybe as sound effects and storms and stuff, I'll just jump somewhere towards the end. Even if you can see that there are some flashlights of flashes of storm go ahead, they would not go synchronized with actual events. The thunder that happens outside in the storm is not put one to one with what's happening in the film itself. Something that we would think is a mistake because, you know, you definitely see the flashes of the thunderstorm and you don't hear the thunder. So that's kind of explainable by thinking about what was the intent. And the last example that I want to bring is so-called Mickey Mousing, where you kind of synchronize to the extent that it almost becomes funny. So just as a little excerpt here, and I will let you can explore this more in detail. So here it's just a one-to-one. And let's go to some fun part here. The reason I want you to get familiar with these ideas and examples is that now once you can feel a little bit more confident and comfortable with manipulating sounds, creating music, and the fact that we don't really need to stay loyal to specific musical examples, and we can also use more recordings, and I will talk maybe either today, depending on how many people will show up and want me to talk about some specific stuff, or if not, I'll record also. I'll try to explain about manipulating sounds with audacity. So once you have recordings, once you have sounds, or you have tools that can manipulate and create very abstract sounds, these sets of examples provide you a little insight into, you know, the possible choices, the possible artistic choices and the design of how you would relate your music to the next scene. I will stop right now and I will talk about also the assignment separately, where we kind of want to use abstract and contemporary composition techniques for a battle scene. So maybe battle scene is more like this dark, hard sounds or something which is really taking you away from the more traditional ways of composition. And that's kind of the focus of this week's homework as well. Okay, so let me stop the recording and answer some questions.